Hello guys, I have made video for you. This is the educational video. It's a part of anatomy and physiology. If you like my video, then please subscribe my channel and like the video. Thank you. Hello guys, I Shraddha Gajjar. Today I am going to teach you about the thyroid gland and parathyroid gland. Now we will see the anatomy of the thyroid gland. In that, first we will see the location. The thyroid gland is situated in the neck in front of larynx and trachea, where at the level of the 5th, 6th and 7th cervical vertebra and 1st thoracic vertebra. Weight 25 grams, shape butterfly in shape. It consists two lobes and they join by a narrow end, that is the isthmus. The two lobes are roughly cone shaped, about 5 cm long and 3 cm wide. Now, blood supply of the thyroid gland. The arterial blood supply, that is the superior and inferior thyroid artery, and venous drainage, that is the thyroid veins which drain into the internal jugular veins. What about the nerve supply? That is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. Now the hormone of the thyroid gland, that is the T3 and T4. Okay, T3 that is the triiodothyronin and T4 that is the thyroxine. These both are very essential. Okay, iodine is very essential for the formation of the thyroid hormone. Now the dietary sources of iodine, that are the seafood and vegetables grown in iodine rich soil and iodinated table salt. The thyroid gland selectively takes up iodine from the blood and process called the iodine trapping. Okay. Now we will see in detail. First is T3, that is the triiodothyronin. It affects almost every physiological process in body. First, that is the helpful for the growth and development, for the metabolism of the food, maintaining body temperature and heart rate. Now, T4, that is the thyroxine. It is very helpful and controls the development and the maturation. Excess thyroxine result rapid development, and deficiency of thyroxine result in delayed development. So it is very helpful to control the development and maturation of our body. Now, the effects of the abnormal secretion of the thyroid hormone. First, that is the hyperthyroidism. In that, increased T3 and T4 secretion. And second, that is the hypothyroidism. In that, as the name suggests, the hypo, there will be decreased amount of the T3 and T4 secretion. Now, what is hyperthyroidism? In that, we will see the features or clinical symptoms, that is the increased basal metabolic rate, while in hypothyroidism there will be decreased metabolic rate. Then the weight loss and good appetite in hyperthyroidism. Then in hypothyroidism there will be weight gain due to the decreased basal metabolic rate. Then in hyperthyroidism there will be anxiety, physical restlessness and mental excitability. While in hypothyroidism, depression, psychosis, mental slowness and lethargy. While in hyperthyroidism, there will be the hair loss. In hypothyroidism, there is the dry skin and brittle, or we can say brittle hair, or we can say dry hair. Then the hyperthyroidism increase the T3 and T4 secretion. That's why there will be tachycardia, palpitation and atrial fibrillation. While in hypothyroidism, there will be bradycardia. Now, warm, sweaty skin, heat tolerance in the hyperthyroidism, and dry, cold skin and prone to hypothermia, that is the hypothyroidism. In hyperthyroidism, there will be a chances of the diarrhea due to the increased metabolic rate, and in hypothyroidism there will be the constipation due to the decreased basal metabolic rate. So these are the common symptoms of the hyperthyroidism and the hypothyroidism. Now Next hormone, that is the calcitonin. It is secreted by the C cells of the thyroid gland, and main action is increase the blood bone calcium and decrease the blood calcium. It is very important and essential in the childhood, because at that time bone goes the very considerable changes in size and shape. That's why it is very important. Now, calcitonin has the opposite action of the parathyroid hormone, because calcitonin absorb the calcium from blood and they will be deposited into the bone, while parathyroid hormone main action, that is increase the calcium level into the blood, so that it has the opposite action. Now, thyroid gland is not absolutely essential for life, but its removal in adult leads to poor resistance to cold and mental and physical slowness, while in children it causes mental retardation and dwarfism. What is dwarfism? That I explained in previous video. Now, the regulation of thyroid secretion. The negative feedback regulation of the secretion of the T4 and T3. That is, the thyroid stimulating hormone control the regulation of the thyroid hormone. Okay. And thyroid TSH will be produced from the anterior pituitary gland, and the releasing hormone will produce from the hypothalamus. Okay, that is the thyroid TRH. The release of the TSH by the anterior lobe of the pituitary, and it is regulated by the hypothalamus. Okay, you can see in the figure, from the hypothalamus, TRH releasing thyroid releasing hormone will trigger the TSH, and TSH will be produced into the anterior pituitary gland. They will secrete T4 and T3 from the thyroid gland. So these are the channels. If T3 and T4 level will be high, then pituitary gland will stop to release the T3 and T4 into the blood. So this is the negative feedback. Now we will see the disease related to the thyroid gland. In that, first one is a goiter. You all know what is goiter. It is enlargement of the thyroid gland, that is called the goiter. It is caused due to the iodine deficiency. Which are the characteristic? In that, first one is a swelling in the neck, breathing difficulty, coughing, hoarseness of voice, swallowing difficulty. So these are the symptoms. Now, second disease condition, that is the hypothyroidism. I explained already. It is a condition resulting from the reduced circulating level of T3 and T4. Okay, due to the it name suggests, that is the hypo means decrease the level of T3 and T4. What is the characteristic feature? That is the goiter, puffiness of face, periorbital swelling, loss of scalp hairs. Ptosis means dropping of upper eyelid, then the dry and thickened, rough and yellow skin. Third one is a hyperthyroidism, or we can say Graves' disease. Okay, in that, increased amount of the T3 and T4 level into the blood. Which are the features? Moderate enlargement of thyroid gland and the exophthalmos means lid retraction. You can see in the figure what is exophthalmos, that is protruding eyes. Now we have completed thyroid gland, we will see the parathyroid gland. Now in humans there are 4 parathyroid glands. You can see in the figure, that is shown in yellow color, that is 4 parathyroid gland. It is very essential for life, and is there, and their removal can cause the death from the asphyxia. What is asphyxia? That you know. Now the anatomy. In that, the first location, 4 small parathyroid glands, 2 embedded into the posterior surface of the each lobe of the thyroid gland. okay, it is embedded into the thyroid gland. They are surrounded by the fine connective tissue capsules and shape, that is the spherical, or we can say the oval. They are arranged in a column, okay, each side 2 parathyroid glands are there, and total 4 parathyroid glands. Color yellowish brown, size 6 mm long, 3 to 4 mm wide, and 1 to 2 mm anterior posteriorly. Now we'll see the function of the parathyroid hormone. It consists, or it contains, chief cells which secrete the parathyroid hormone. You can see in the figure, there is the chief cells are there. The main function of the parathyroid hormone, that increase the blood calcium level. Now we'll see the disease condition related to the parathyroid gland. In that, first one is rickets. It is disease characterized mainly by the bone deformities in young children. Okay, in rickets there will be a bone deformity in young children. The disease of the children sets in about 6 months of life. Okay, at the 6 month we can identify this is the rickets. Which are the characteristic features? Deformed bones. You can see in the figure, there will be the deformed bones. Then thick wrist and ankles. Then retarded growth. So these are the symptoms. Second, that is the osteomalacia. This is due to inadequate absorption of the calcium due to the deficiency of the vitamin D and calcium in the diet. So there will be the leg amount or leg absorption of the calcium because of the deficiency of vitamin D and calcium intake in your diet. This disease is limited to females, usually appears after the multiple pregnancy and the lactation. Okay, because of the multiple pregnancy and lactation, there will be the leg amount of the vitamin D and calcium in the body. Now, third, that is the hypoparathyroidism, means low level of calcium into the blood. Okay, which are the characteristic features? Psychiatric disturbance, paresthesias, and development of the cataract. So these are the symptoms. So this is the hypoparathyroidism. Okay, low level or decreased level of the parathyroid hormone. Fourth one is hyperparathyroidism, means excessive secretion of the parathyroid hormone. Which are the characteristic features? In that, the formulation of renal calculi, means renal stone, polyuria, excessive amount of urination, polydipsia, then the anorexia, loss of appetite, then the muscle weakness, okay, general fatigue, and calcification of the soft tissue. So these are the clinical features of the hyperparathyroidism. So I have completed my topic, that is the thyroid gland and parathyroid gland. Now if you have any query, any question, you can ask me. Before that, you don't forget to like and share my video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.